I just want it to be better than Quibi. That's all I want. We'll see. What is up, Flick fans? Welcome back to my channel. We have another streaming service to talk about. I did a similar video with HBO Max where I just went through the entire platform, talked about what it has to offer at this moment, and if it's worth buying. With HBO Max, you had to actually buy it. With Peacock, there is a free option. Austin, what the heck is Peacock? Today we're going to talk about it and kind of look forward to the future of what it's bringing to the platform. I need your comments down below. Are you guys planning on getting the free version of Peacock? Are you going to pay for the premium version? And I do want to say it launched in the United States today. As far as other countries, I'm not for sure when you are going to get this platform. So if you'd like to see what you're looking forward to, stick around. But if not, I completely understand. So let's get into talking about Peacock, the fact that it just launched this morning. It is a streaming service from the Comcast-owned NBC Universal, and it is launching with a 7-day free trial for its premium tiers and a free tier in general that you can sign up for, you don't have to pay for. And on that free tier, you are actually able to sample about 2/3 of its library. So you're not getting everything that Peacock has to offer, but you're getting quite a bit. Now, we will talk about the distinction of the tiers here in just a second, but in terms of what Peacock has to offer with how many shows and movies, we have about 20,000 hours of TV shows, movies, news, sports, and special highlight-esque videos along with the original programming. Now, a big talking point about HBO Max was the fact that it did not launch with Roku or Amazon Fire TV, which is, in general, the way that a lot of people consume these streaming services. I have a Roku on my television. Unfortunately, it's the exact same case for Peacock. While it will be launching on PlayStation 4 consoles and certain smart TVs, there is no deal in place for Roku or Amazon Fire TV devices. And in terms of those two companies reaching an agreement, it's not looking good that it's going to happen within the next couple of weeks. So we may have to wait at least a month or two for that to happen, maybe even longer. And honestly, these deals aren't too bad. So if you purchase annually, you can get Peacock with ads for $30 and without ads for $80. Now, that's a large price jump for sure, but ads versus ad-free in a lot of people's minds is a big distinction. So $80 still isn't the worst we've seen for a streaming service. We just have to go through their catalog. Now, on a per-month basis, there are, like I said, three tiers. One that is a limited tier. It is free. The next tier up, you'll have to pay $4.99 a month, and that is everything it has to offer with advertisements. And the final one is $9.99 a month. No ads, everything they have, originals, their TV channels, sports, all of that wonderful stuff. It's a pretty good deal when you're comparing it to certain other more expensive streaming platforms. But again, it all comes down to the content. So now if you're not too upset that it's not going to be on Roku and you are willing to maybe pay a bit of money or just do without some of the content, I do want to go through exactly what Peacock has to offer. Now, I do want to preface with the fact that I did purchase the second tier of Peacock, meaning I get access to all of the content. So you're not going to be seeing exactly what the free version has to offer, but according to the articles that I've read, the free version has pretty much everything except for some of the movies, a few of the shows, still has access to the originals, but you can only watch a few episodes. Then you have to up your tier. So if you're wanting to watch the Peacock originals, you're probably going to have to pay a bit of money, but you will be able to see everything they have to offer. I just have to watch it with advertisements. Oh, and I did get the 7-day free trial technically, so I have 7 days to do whatever I want, then I have to start paying. So first off, let's look at the layout. A bit of a different layout than what we're used to seeing with something like Disney Plus and HBO Max. We do have the bar up top where you can select whatever you are intending to watch. So right now, we're just going to stick to the browse section. And obviously, they're going to highlight some of their originals. So we have Brave New World and Psych 2, which is a movie sequel to Psych. So that's pretty cool. Some of their cornerstone shows, such as Yellowstone, something I've heard a lot about, The King of Queens, and Shrek. We're also delving into the movie world. Plenty of films that we're going to have access to. And again, not all of them are going to be available on that free tier, but we're going to check them out. One thing I wanted to look at, though, is this featured channels section. So we're covering NBC here. That's why it's called Peacock. We got the colored feathers, all of that wonderful stuff. We have access to not only live news and live shows such as the Today Show, but we also have access to sports. So we're going to skip through some of these and go straight to that sports section and talk about the fact that they do have the Premier League highlighted on this platform. And I believe if we go over to channels, we will be able to see actual Premier League matches. So for fans of sports in general, I think you're going to want to check this out. And going back over to that sports tier, I did see a top sports stories section, and I'm seeing some NFL content down here, and NBC is actually the home of certain football games weekly, so there is a chance that you'll be able to go back and check out those games on Peacock. So if you're a sports fan, you're getting a pretty good array of content here, from soccer to football in the United States, to sports highlights, and then of course, documentaries, which are showcased in the sports category as well. So pretty good range of sports content, as well as the Olympics. So when the Olympics come, whenever that happens, it will be highlighted on this platform. So this is something that not other streaming platforms have as much of. But in my opinion, it may be one of the best things that they have to offer, as well as a couple of Peacock originals, Lost Speedways with Dale Earnhardt Jr., and In Deep with Ryan Lochte. So let's go back over to channels and something really interesting. So you can basically pick what you want to watch. We have Saturday Night Live. You click on it. It comes up on screen. You have The Office, which shows random clips of The Office. Not full episodes just yet, but clips. And plenty of categories such as The Tonight Show, Sky News, basically anything owned by NBC Universal, you get access to that. So we've kind of covered what the channel section has to offer, what the sports section has to offer. Let's go back to browse and kind of browse through and look at some of these Peacock originals, which are, again, exclusive, the entire season's exclusive to premium. Brave New World, The Capture, Intelligence, Psych 2, and this Dale Earnhardt and Ryan Lochte special show, as well as some kids content as well. So if you're looking for some kids content, we have Where's Waldo, Curious George, all of these Peacock originals. Pretty good array of content. But here's the thing. These shows look interesting, for sure. If you're a fan of Psych, you're going to love seeing this sequel. If you're a fan of David Schwimmer, you're going to check out Intelligence. Brave New World looks like the most interesting of the shows, in my opinion. But nothing stands out as worth the money just yet. First of all, I have to see how these shows are, so I'm going to check them out for myself and hopefully give you guys some recommendations later on in the week or next week. But then you look at the wide array of original content on something like Netflix. Granted, it's been in place for a while, and it's had time to build itself up, and it took a while to get there. But the same way I felt about HBO Max, it's like, oh, they have stuff, original stuff, but many aren't necessarily going to tune in for these originals. They're just going to be shows and movies that they just catch, you know. Oh, that looks interesting. I'm here for The Office. I'm here for Parks and Rec. But I'll check this out right now and see how it goes. Oh, and speaking of The Office, we're not quite there yet. The Office is still on Netflix for you all to watch, and most of you guys have Netflix, but it is going away and coming exclusively to Peacock eventually. As of right now, we do have Parks and Rec. We do have shows like Law and Order, Yellowstone, classics, in my opinion, shows that I grew up with, like Everybody Hates Chris, 30 Rock, so some reasonable TV shows, especially if you're a fan of sitcoms, George Lopez, Frasier, and then you have your fun live-action shows like An America's Got Talent, dramas like Downton Abbey, Parenthood, basically anything you're going to find on NBC, whether it's old or new. So if you're a fan of that network, then you're probably going to want to get Peacock so you can check out all of your exclusive content. But for me, the two major marquee keystone shows, Parks and Rec, which they already have, and The Office. That's going to be the draw to this platform, especially when it leaves Netflix. But as of right now, you can check it out in the channels section. but it is not a show that is available just yet. In terms of movies, they have an interesting array of films. American Psycho, Do the Right Thing, Jurassic Park, that franchise, Shrek, The Blair Witch Project, The Bourne Identity, The Matrix, The Mummy, You, Me, and Dupree. Some good films. Some movies that I think people are going to find interesting and entertaining. Some big-time blockbuster franchises like Jurassic Park or Matrix that they're going to throw on top of something like Tully and Forgetting Sarah Marshall. Again, it's difficult to measure up to the HBO catalog of films because they're constantly going in and out with those kinds of big-time movies. But movies that are good enough. I love this Rotten Tomatoes approved section, by the way. These are going to showcase and highlight probably your better movies. Some films that I'm not going to love on here, obviously, because we all don't feel the same way, but some good movies in this section: comic relief, serious cinema, action adventure, your standard categories. I love this cult corner here, showcasing Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas and Howard the Duck, and some pretty interesting Nicolas Cage. Everybody loves a good Nicolas Cage section. And you have a beautiful film like Short Term 12. So, interesting enough categories there, and some movies that everyone is going to enjoy. Let's go to the kids section, just in case you're getting this for your young ones, Tiny Tots animated comedy. We have some classics like Woody the Woodpecker, 3-2-1 Penguins? Are you kidding me? I used to love that show. That's kind of cool. Shrek, for some reasons, in the kids section. Animated Adventure, Beat the Summer Heat. So you're going to find some things on here that maybe you grew up with, that maybe your kids have grown up with, that you've not been able to find. Not the biggest array of kids content, but again, there are Peacock Originals, and there will be more of those. So I do think this may be something you can throw on for your kids and let them browse through this section. Like I said earlier, they do have news. Anything owned by NBC, whether it's talking about the Olympics, whether it's talking about politics or sports, you can find in that section. And something I find extremely cool is they have a Latino section showcasing various movies and television shows and events from the Latino community. I think that is awesome. I love seeing something like that on a platform like this, and you're going to find some interesting content that you're not going to find in any of these other sections. I have to be completely honest with you, just browsing through this and seeing all of these options available and noticing the originals that we have so far, we're not quite there yet with what they have planned and schemed for us, but some interesting things. I don't know if Peacock is living up to the hype that it has tried to give off just yet. There are things on here that I'm going to enjoy. There are movies on here that I'm going to like, and there are originals that I'm most likely going to review. But Peacock is not quite there in terms of a wide array of content or content that is going to make it worth purchasing just yet. There's definitely enough. And I don't mean to sound like someone who is sitting here and complaining, oh, we get a free streaming service. I am going to encourage everyone to sign up for the free version of this and see what all it has to offer. See which movies and TV shows don't quite make it in to that free tier. And if the originals are worth it, maybe it will be worth going up. Because again, $10 isn't the worst thing ever. Heck, the second tier isn't the worst thing ever. I don't mind advertisements if I'm saving a bit of money. But again, these are shows and movies that I've just seen enough of before. And the fact that it's not on Roku or Fire Stick just yet is probably going to keep someone like me. Now, again, I have purchased it just because I will be reviewing the originals, but it's probably going to keep someone like me away from purchasing a platform like this just yet. But again, we have to see what Peacock does, and we have to see how I feel when The Office leaves Netflix, because I think that's when a lot of people are going to flock over to Peacock. I need your all's comments down below. From what you've seen today, from all of the content that Peacock has to offer, what are you guys thinking about this new streaming service, about this new platform? Are you upset that it's not available on Roku? Do you think it has a wide enough array of content? Comparing it to something like an HBO Max, which we got recently. Quibi? I'd probably prefer it over Quibi. I still think HBO Max has so much more to offer in terms of categories and content. Maybe not originals, maybe about the same in terms of the original programming. But Peacock, I just need to see more from this platform, and we need to see how it improves functionality-wise. Again, the layout is fine, the color scheme is okay, the black background doesn't quite do much for it to pop in my mind, but there is enough there that I think warrants you all to at least try out. Thank you so much for watching this video. Are you interested, like I said? And if you enjoy these streaming service-centric videos, be sure to smash that thumbs up button. I'll see you guys soon.